Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here, New Life Pentecostal Church, Albany, Georgia. I want to talk just a little bit about Pentecostals who believe in the King James Version, and specifically Apostolic Pentecostals or Oneness Pentecostals. Now, as I've been doing videos, there has been a kind of a delineation between what does the term apostolic mean, because there's evidently a large movement, the charismatic movement called the New Apostolic Reformation, that talks about the reclamation of the seven mountains of culture, you know, education, movies and schools and just different things, education, schools, same thing, government and all this. But what I mean by apostolics, those that believe in the apostolic doctrine, you know, Jesus is absolutely God, oneness of God, Acts 2:38, holiness, that's what I mean. So and now, all these, you know, you can check with the people that I'm going to talk about. It's always a dangerous thing, they say, to ascribe beliefs to somebody. And beliefs are fluid sometimes. You know, what Martin Luther believed in 1520 might not have believed in 1540. But let's just look at some apostolics who believe in the King James Version. Now, like in the group I'm with, the United Pentecostal Church International, not only would we have in our manual under a position paper that we would say that the King James Version of the Bible is to be used among our people, amongst our churches, all of this, but in the Bible, its origin and use, in chapters, what, 6, I think it is, would say that the King James Version is the Word of God, and go into dramatic defense. The Pentecostal Herald back in the 1980-81 would go into very big defense of the King James Version of the Bible. And then, like, the three of the largest churches in the UPC that I know of would believe that the King James Version is the Word of God, and would say that it's the best translation, such as Brother Haney out in Stockton, Nathaniel Haney. Now, if he doesn't believe that, I apologize, but that's my understanding. I've been told several people that he does. I know Brother Mooney at Calvary Tabernacle certainly does, and I know at the Mangans that they certainly do. They have Brother Steve Smart, who teaches it to every level every year, of why they believe the King James Version of the Bible. And Brother Mangan himself, younger, has said, my daddy always said if we left the King James Version of the Bible, we'd be charismatic within 5 years. So you got that. And then Brother Carpenter, who's the current superintendent of the Assemblies of the Lord Jesus Christ, is a big King James proponent, as is Nathaniel Wilson, who is one of the co-founders of the Worldwide Pentecostal Fellowship. He's very strong on the King James Version of the Bible as well. So you've got, you know, three predominant organizations and people within the organizations and apostolic leaders that are very strong on the King James Version of the Bible. And I do know the Bible College at the ALJC Bible College used to be very strong on it as well. I would assume it still is. And then you have the Pentecostal Assemblies of the World, according to the Handbook of Denominations, would be very strong on the predominance of the King James Version of the Bible. I know, like, the largest Bible college, Apostolic Bible College in North America, Indiana Bible College, would again be very strong on the King James Version of the Bible. Guys like the Bible College, CSTI, in Southern California with Art Hodges, and that they have this great lesson on why Pentecostals use the King James Version of the Bible and why they consider it the best translation of the Bible. So there's a lot of apostolics and Pentecostals. Sometimes it's kind of presented that it's some backwater view or something, when in reality it's always been the mainstream view of Pentecostals for the, you know, since at least the 1955. A lot of people don't know in the early 50s, I forget if it's 53, 55, I always get those two dates messed up. But when they put that position paper in the United Pentecostal Church manual of the primacy of the King James Version of the Bible, even all the literature at Publishing House, Pentecostal Publishing House, till recently at least, had to go through the Benjamin Blaney Second Folio Edition, 1769, you know, making sure that was the correct King James that they used, text they used. that all the Bible colleges in the EPC got together showing why the King James should be used and the Revised Standard, of which almost all modern translations beside the New King James, and then some of the minor ones like the MEV and all this, would be followed after, as the United Pentecostal Church Sunday School literature points out in the Bible Its Origin and Use, they all follow the RSV, that why that should not be. So there was actually a presentation, a general conference of all the Bible colleges getting together. So, you know, it's just always been a very strong position, but we're in the end time, and strong positions are becoming less strong. God bless. I love you in Jesus' name.